Fala rapaziada, começando mais um vídeo aqui no canal Na Ponta da Língua e sejam bem-vindos para mais um vídeo. Bom, vocês pediram muito, vocês insistiram bastante, depois de meses e meses me pedindo, tá de volta o quadro Inglês com os Inscritos. Não só o quadro tá de volta, na verdade, mas tá de volta eu também praticando meu inglês. Tava aí umas 3 semanas sem falar inglês. Vocês acham que é só vocês que passam crise? Não, eu também passo aí por umas dessas. Então tá de volta aí o quadro Inglês com os Inscritos, tá de volta aí eu praticando meu inglês, tentando melhorar cada vez mais junto com vocês. Hoje eu falei com o Lucas, um inscrito muito legal, um moleque super gente boa, gente finíssima. Se você quiser saber como participar do próximo Inglês com os Inscritos, é só você me seguir no Instagram e ficar ligado nos meus stories. Quando for pra ter Inglês com os Inscritos, eu vou postar uma caixinha de pergunta lá nos stories perguntando quem quer participar. E aí você só precisa falar eu, botar seu nome e deixar entender que você quer. Logo em seguida eu vou estar fazendo um sorteio, porque infelizmente não tem como eu conversar com todo mundo que bota o nome lá. E aí se você for sorteado, eu vou te chamar lá no direct, a gente vai combinar certinho quando a gente vai fazer, como vai ser. Então, sem muito mais enrolações, que eu sei que vocês estavam com saudades, vamos aí pro principal, que é o conteúdo em inglês com os inscritos.
Hey man, what's up?
Hey, what's up, dude? How are you doing?
I'm doing well. What about you?
I'm great. Now I'm good, but a few days ago I was sick, man. I thought it was COVID, but I did the test and it wasn't.
Oh, thank God, right?
Thanks, God.
What's your name?
My name is Lucas. I'm from Teresina, Piauí, the same state of Whindersson Nunes.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I saw your video that you met him, right?
Yeah, yes, right. So, can you introduce yourself, please? Like, who are you?
So, how I said, I'm Lucas. I'm from Teresina. And some people don't believe, but I'm only 17 years old.
Wait, really?
Yeah, really, bro. I'm only 17.
No, I'm older than you, bro.
Yeah, you're older.
Oh my God, okay.
And I'm finishing my high school. I graduating this year. And I also do some commercial videos. I have a job as a filmmaker, you know?
Oh, nice, nice. Wait, but are you turning 18 this year?
Yeah, this year in August.
As you said, you are what? Filmmaker?
A filmmaker. Yeah, I do some commercial videos for some companies, you know. The last that I did was from a barbershop. I did a commercial video. It's on my Instagram. If you want to see, go there, you know.
But how did you start in this occupation?
So, when I was a little kid, I had a YouTube channel, like you, but I did vlogs, you know, and since that time, I always edit videos, and I like that, so I saw this as an opportunity to make some money, you know, and I like it, and yeah, it's the thing that I want to my life. I'm gonna do college. I'm gonna do a cinema college, you know.
Did you learn it by yourself? Because yeah. I learned by myself, you know.
It's pretty easy actually. It's funny. It's funny to edit videos. I like it. So let me ask you one thing. Before you do the videos talking about English, you did videos about skate, right?
Skateboarding. Right. Yes.
Yeah, I remember you, bro. I saw your videos. The name of the channel was Tanabazi, right?
Yeah, exactly.
I skate too.
Oh, that's nice.
With the long hair.
Yes, the long hair. I started skating in 2011, you know, but I stopped it and I start again in 2015, I guess. Yeah.
Do you use 2K?
Right now, I'm not, you know, because I'm so busy with, you know, English and a lot of stuff. But I'd like to go back.
I like it. I like it so much. I started when I was a kid, too. I was like, I don't know, maybe 11 years old. And I broke my wrist in that time. And my father didn't want me to go ahead to keep skating.
What's your favorite trick?
Flip. It's a beautiful trick. And it's the last trick that I learned, you know?
Oh, nice. So my favorite trick is, you know, hard flip.
Parkley is so pretty too.
Yes.
Beautiful trick, bro.
I remember once I jumped a stair, you know, with hard flip. It was nice.
Do it hard flip?
I'm going to try to put this part in this video, okay? Dude, and you can see.
You have the video?
Yes, I have. Yes. It wasn't, you know, pretty well like Luan de Oliveira, but it was nice. It was nice. It was my first time, you know, jumping a stair.
Cool. I just jumped stair doing ollie, bro. It's the only thing that I know.
About English, why did you decide to learn English? Okay. And how do you study English? How do you learn English?
Since I was a kid, my father always told me, like, oh, English is important. You have to learn English, because he learned English too. And since that time, I always studied English, but no formally, like, studying the grammar, reading books. But I always watch movies with subtitles and, you know, with the immersion. And I learned English in this way, you know, always listen to music in English, trying to figure out what the guy are saying in music, and watching movie, TV shows. And this is the way that I learned English. But I never studied grammar or something, you know.
Do you have some favorite TV show or movie?
Yeah, actually, I learned a lot with one TV show that it doesn't have much on Netflix. Netflix take it off. It was That 7th Show. I don't know if you heard about it. It's a really good TV show because the English is easy. doesn't have so many
slangs, expressions, yeah. Right?
Yeah, it's a basic English, and the episodes have just 20 minutes. It's very short. It's cool to learn with this TV show.
My moment TV show right now is Grey's Anatomy. So I'm not sure if I am able to watch, you know, totally in English. I watch in English, but with subtitles in Portuguese. Grey's Anatomy is a hard TV show because there are a lot of vocabularies, hard vocabularies that, you know, about medicine, surgery, and a lot of, you know, crazy things.
I never watched Grey's Anatomy, but I saw your video that you watched that Netflix movie.
Run, right?
Yeah, Run. I watched this movie too, but it was with Portuguese subtitles. I don't know, like, every day I try to watch some YouTube video or movie in English with English subtitles. It's very good to practice your listening.
And what's your favorite YouTubers?
The English YouTubers?
Yes, right. Yeah. Like Karina Fragoso, you know?
I know. I watch Nico. I don't know if you heard about him.
No.
Yeah, it's Nico. It's an American YouTuber. He's from New York, and he does some videos talking about the life and how the things work and about the things in general, you know. But it's very cool because he edited the video in a way that it's very cool to watch, you know.
Is it for people who are learning English or, you know, everybody?
It's for everybody, but if you wanna watch this channel, you gotta have a pretty cool level in listening English, you know.
Yes.
If you understand what I'm trying to say, because my listening is so better. It's much better than my speaking, you know, because I listen more than I speak, and it's normal, I guess.
How long have you been learning English? Because you speak very well, really. For real.
Thank you, bro. But as I said, since I was a kid, I don't have a date that I started.
Oh, don't you have a specifically time, a specific moment?
No. Actually, I don't know how I'm talking English right now, you know?
But, like, do you study? Like, do you have an English notebook? You write?
No, I don't do this.
Oh, my God. That's crazy.
I never studied grammar, you know?
Uh-huh.
The English that I know is from TV shows, movies, and songs.
You told me about something about Cambly. Do we have classes on Cambly?
Yeah. In the end of the last year, I started on Cambly and I did some classes, but to improve my speaking, because as I said, my listening is so much better than my speaking. In English is a good way to improve your speaking, because you're like face to face talking with the native people.
And what do you think about the platform? What do you think about Cambly?
It's a very good platform, but as you said in some video, the English that we talk there is very, I don't know how to say.
Formal.
Yeah, very formal English. And it's cool to talk with people in other platforms like, I don't remember now, that you...
Amigo.
Yeah, Amigo, and there's some other platforms to do it.
I'm in a moment that I'd like to have, you know, an informal English. Yeah. You know, I'd like to say, hey, bro, what's up? How's it going?
Yes, sir.
But, yes, in Cambly, we say, hi, hello, how are you? Oh, yeah. Where are you from? I'm from Brazil. Oh, nice.
it's too formal.
Yes, exactly. So, bro, it was a pleasure to talk to you today, right?
Yeah, it was a pleasure talking to you, too.
You were very good. You speak English very well, really.
Thank you, man.
So, I hope to see you again. I hope we talk again, right?
All right.
Okay, bro. Bye.
Bye.
É isso aí, rapaziada. Esse foi o vídeo. Se você gostou, deixa o seu like aqui embaixo. Compartilhe com algum amigo seu, vai estar me ajudando muito. Se você não me segue no Instagram, me segue lá. O link vai estar aqui na descrição. Se quiser participar do próximo Inglês com Inscritos, é por lá que eu vou selecionar as pessoas. Então me segue lá e fica ligado. O que você achou do vídeo também? Deixa um comentário aqui embaixo. E é isso, galera. Muito obrigado pelo seu like e a sua visualização. Vejo vocês no próximo vídeo. Tamo junto e valeu!